coin toss, and it's brought to you by Coke Zero. Real Coca-Cola taste, zero calories. Enjoy everything. The kicker's got the ball set up, and we're ready to get this thing started. He really got a hold of that kick. This one's going to be down in the end zone for a touchback. The quarterback brings his troops out of the field for the first drive of the game. The quarterback in the gun, empty backfield, five wide receivers in the formation. Quick pass, tight end, and he wasn't ready for it. It's second and 10. Ball on their own 25. And he stopped behind the line.
He wasn't decisive at all on that option. And once he kept it himself, there was no place to go.
They'll line up with five wide receivers. Quick throw out to the receiver, incomplete. Well, the defense stood tall there.
Boy, the defense did what they had to do to get three and out and now get the offense back on the field.
Brought down at the 49-yard line. The Mustangs, been talking with them this week, Kirk, is just interesting. Their perspective on this kid, how good he is, and how much they can lean on him.
Yeah, you and I had a chance to visit with not only the coaches, but the player himself, and I got a real good vibe walking out of those meetings and thinking that he's going to have a huge game. The coaches seem confident in being able to get him the football in different areas on the field. This kid has a look in his eye that I haven't seen in a long time where he just wants to have a chance to have an impact on the game and on the outcome. And I'd be shocked if they can slow him down.
From their own 48-yard line. Second down. On the pitch, look out, loose ball. Recovered by the defense. He really wanted that ball, didn't he, Kirk?
Man, you can't teach hustle like that. The linebacker was determined to get the ball there, and he did.
I don't think either team has a clear advantage so far. Let's see if they can make some plays and get a little separation. Fires quick out to the receiver and he can't make the grab. From the 47-yard line, it's second down. Out to his receiver, and he is drilled at the 33. They must have seen something in the defense because that was the exact same play as the one they ran before.
Exactly the same play. The defense better make some adjustments because right now there's a mismatch that the offense has taken advantage of.
He's on the run. Tackle at the 20-yard line. So he keeps it, and he gets a big first down.
The quarterback made a very good decision here not to pitch. He saw a break in the defense and just hit it for a big gain.
From the 20-yard line, it's first down. Third and 10 coming up. Ball on the 20-yard line.
It's a bad play overall by the offense. The quarterback's doing everything he can to be able to make the play work and try to execute. The problem is the offensive line did not do a good job protecting him. They're very fortunate that ball wasn't intercepted.
This to try to put his team up by a field goal. Kicks away, and it's Putsy uprights. board. Fields at the goal line. He lost the ball. It's scooped up. And he's finally brought down at the 3-yard line. Let's get some points going right now. Not a lot of offense here in the opening quarter.
I'm with you. I'd like to see a lot more offense than we've seen up to this point. Give credit to the defenses, but I think you're going to see both these offense coordinators get more of a feel for things and start to adjust their play call.
So now both teams come trotting back out onto the field. They line up in the jumbo set. Bowen gets a call, and it pays off. Touchdown. And it looks like they're ready for the kickoff. He'll return it from the 6. Gets out to about the 21. The Wildcats are looking downright scary on defense so far, Irby.
They are flying around as a group right now, completely aware of what this offense is trying to do and dismantling them every single time on every single play.
Well, I'm sure the offense will be looking to avoid the turnover that ended their last drive.
The game is in danger of getting out of hand early. It's very, very important that they not only hang on to the football this drive, but they also need to get a score on the board as well.
That brings us second and 9.
It's 2nd and 9. Ball on the 22-yard line. And down he goes, around the 26-yard line. Swings it out there incomplete. He let that pass get away from him.
I think he's a little bit anxious. He actually looked a little bit too juiced that time, and he'll get the next one.
And they're coming after this punter. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. He gets hit out of bounds at the 46. Not sure that touchdown on their last possession's given them some confidence, but let's see if that carries them back down the field. To that quickly. He's taken down at the 35-yard line.
That's great execution. Quarterback made a nice throw, and the receiver was able to go up and make the play.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on the 35. To the halfback on the screen. And they push him out at the 23-yard line. He lets it fly. Fires quickly. Touchdown. Tacks on the extra point. So a short 3-play, 55-yard drive, and it results in a touchdown. So our score, 17-0. Looks like they're ready for the kick. From his own goal line, he gets out to about the 18-yard line. The Wildcats really came prepared to play defense today, and the plan is working.
Well, so far in this game, you've got to tip your cap to the defensive coordinator. He has clearly done a very good job of getting his team ready to play, and they have done a nice job of slowing down this very explosive offense.
They need to show a little giddy up now, because if they don't start eating into this deficit, they could easily fall out of the game. He's tackled at the 18-yard line. Second down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 18. And he makes it out to about the 21-yard line.
That's good for a game.
Strike to his receiver. No good.
Johnson's intended receiver on the play. Fourth down.
This is a great punt blocking team, and it looks like they're going to try to get to this one. He really got a hold of that one. He dropped it. They'll bring him down to the 39-yard line. Let's find out if the defense has made any adjustments after giving up a touchdown on that last drive.
You can bet this defense made some adjustments on the sideline, though. I don't know if they can stop the passing attack, but they need to at least be able to slow it down. Boy, did you see how the defense just swarmed to the ball carrier? That was fantastic pursuit.
From their own 36-yard line, second down, the quarterback in the gun with five receivers. Tackle made around the 38-yard line.
That's a gain of two on the play. That makes it third and 11.
Fires incomplete. Van was the intended target on the play, and they're going to have to bring on the punt team.
It was a good hold by the defense on third down. Now their punt returner will get a chance to make something happen.
The punting team's got to give their kicker some time. And he's tackled at the 31. It's not quite a blowout, but unless they do something here, it might turn into one. Pitches out and the ball is up for grabs. The defense has it. That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with the turnover ball. They need to hold on to the football.
The defense did a nice job shutting down the offense the last time they had the ball. He has some room. And he's tackled at the 16-yard line. We're through one quarter. The Wildcats lead it by 17. And we're back for more action here in quarter number two. Taken down around the 4-yard line. First down, and they'll bring it up first and goal inside the 5. And he gets the touchdown. Converts the extra point with a 3-play, 27-yard drive, and it's good for 7 points. They line up to kick this one away. Nice kick, plenty of distance. And they can forget about returning this one.
Well, this defense has got to be proud of what they've been able to do in this football game so far. Love to see the goose eggs up there for this defense. And the way their offense is playing, this game is really shaping together for this team.
Things are on the verge of getting out of hand before we even hit the half. These next few drives are going to go a long way in determining what kind of game this will end up being. Quick out to his receiver.
Besides going deep on the fade, the slant route is probably the most commonly run route against man coverage. If the receiver gets a good inside release, it'll be a new set of downs every time.
Steps out of bounds at the 39. Second and eight coming up here. Ball on their own 39. And he has it on the corner. He's at midfield. They'll bring him down at the 45.
I think the big thing for a defense when they face a screen is chasing it from the inside out, which means the defensive linemen are the key to slowing down a really well-executed screen pass. Because if you think about it, the offensive linemen are getting downfield blocking against the linebackers and the safeties. The defensive linemen have got to be able to recognize screen and then have the quickness to be able to chase the running back down from behind before he gets his momentum going and can outrun him.
Fires it out, and they make the stop around the 39-yard line.
Number 33 brings him down at the 39-yard line.
So it's second down now, and they need about 4 yards to pick up the first. Quick throw. He's brought down in the open field. First.
Just a nice job again up front by the offensive line. They're doing a good job of neutralizing the defensive front, and it's allowed them to move the ball down the field.
Gets it out to his receiver in a hurry.
Brought
down around the 22-yard line. And this is the eighth play of the drive. Zips it out to his runner, and he's got him again.
Tackle at the 14-yard line.
That makes it second and two.
So it's second down and about 2 yards to go. Empty backfield, quarterback in the gun. Five wide receivers. And they'll score. Spectacular run by the quarterback.
That is such a weapon for your offense. When you have a quarterback who can do things like that, the coach probably loves drawing up plays for this guy.
Well, they're going to try for the two-point conversion.
Red two, orange three.
He's in for the conversion. The kicker looks like he's ready to kick this one off. Fields it at the two. It was a pretty one-sided first quarter, but I wouldn't be surprised if things changed in a big way before halftime. Up the middle for a nice gain. Bowen picks up about 4 yards on the play. From their own 26-yard line, it's second down. And he's hit immediately. Gets to about the 41-yard line. Causey gets around three on that option keeper.
You won't break or bend this linebacker. He won't miss that tackle too often.
They come out on an empty backfield. Scrambling around. So the sack makes this third and very long. It all going long. He's got his receiver with nobody around him. And a huge touchdown play. He makes the PAT. A five play, 78-yard drive, and they come away with a touchdown.
Brad, I thought that was a textbook drive. I thought they did a really good job of showing balance, mixing the play calling with the run and the pass, just an overall well-executed touchdown drive.
The Mustangs know, I think, that at some point they just have to do what they do, even if it's not working right now. If they can get it going in the second half, it should really improve the ball game and the offense.
Well, the offensive line, I think, also has to be accountable here. We look so much to our star players, and we always want them to put up big numbers. But to me, the two go hand in hand. When a running back's going to have a great game, the offensive line deserves some credit. When a running back's struggling, you got to look at that offensive line and say, fellas, you got to help me out. We're not going to change or deviate from this game plan. We need to be able to change this game around, and it starts up front with the offensive line.
He's got it out to his tight end. He's pushed out of bounds at the 35. That's good for a gain of 1 yard. From their own 35-yard line, first down. Quick throw, and he's got the tight end again. And down he goes at the 40-yard line.
Number 13 makes the tackle at the 40-yard line. That brings him second and five.
He steps out at the 42-yard line.
Gain 2 yards. That makes it third and three.
Third down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. Good open field tackle. The Mustangs use their second timeout.
Watch 14.
Tries to buy some time. Runs with it. I mean, he's got room. He's taken down at about the 41.
Kill.
That makes it first and 10.
Red, 2, 3, 9.
Throws this one out to the left. He almost had it, but it's incomplete.
Boy, a golden opportunity missed by the defense. That was a sure interception, only to be dropped.
From the 41-yard line, second down. He heaves it to the end zone. Incomplete.
Number 86.
And this is the ninth play of the current drive.
That brings us third and 10.
Dumps it complete to the halfback over the middle. He tackles in for a loss. That's a loss of about 3.
Not much going on there. Those kind of plays will not work against this defense. You can be sure of that.
Looks like they're going to go for it on fourth down. And we'll probably see how far he can throw it, as it should be the last play before the half. Pick. Well, we played a half of football. The Wildcats lead it by 23.
Hi, everybody. Glad to have you with us on the EA Sports NCAA Football 14 Halftime Show, presented by Nissan. Innovation that excites. Davis, David Pollack here in the studio, as always, to lend a little perspective to what just went down in the first 30 minutes. This halftime lead is much larger than any of us anticipated, and now the challenge becomes to maintain it and try to make sure that you don't let the other guy get up off the deck.
Yeah, I think they're probably as surprised as we are, because we thought it was going to be very competitive, but don't sleep on them yet. It's not over. This is still a really good ball club, and I think you got to make sure that you understand that they're even with you most of the time. You just had a big first half. They can have a big second half, so you make sure you come out in the second half, you execute, you try not to make mistakes, but don't sleep on those guys over on the other side.
That's going to do it at halftime, just about ready to start the second half.
All right, you finish it up, bro. I'm going to get something in the cafeteria. I'm hungry.
Wait, don't leave until you get my order. Brad Kirk, take the second half.
And we welcome you back to the action here, just about set for the second half. He'll return it from the six. He makes it out to maybe the 20-yard line.
Personal foul. Face mask. Defense.
All day, baby, all day.
Still first down.
There's got to be some sense of urgency to this offense right now. They don't have the luxury of wasting drives if they want to get back in the game. Catches it, and that's all. That's a 7-yard gain.
The defense wasn't fooled too much by the play action, but it gave the quarterback just enough of a cushion to find his receiver.
Second down, and they're going to need about 3 yards to pick up the first down. He fights forward to about the 43. They got all the big boys in there for this one. Here's an opening. He gets hit out of bounds at about the 39-yard line.
First down.
It's first and 10. Ball on the 39. The middle. They bring him down in the backfield.
Excellent job by the defense to diagnose the play so quickly. This is really a well-coached unit.
Quick strike to the receiver. He's tackled at about the 25-yard line. First and 10, ball on the 25-yard line. Huge play, and it's going to be first and goal. Nice yardage on that run.
That's a that brings up second and goal.
And this play is number 8 on the drive. They're crowding that line of scrimmage. Quick strike to the receiver. Touchdown.
These guys don't get tense down by the end zone. Sometimes a young quarterback will make a silly mistake, or a receiver will come down with a case of stone hands, but not with this group.
So the offense is going to go for two. He's on the run. They don't get it. An 8-play, 65-yard drive, but they just get 6 points after failing to convert for two.
Brad, not only did they put points up on the board, but I think it's the way they did it. Now, that could be demoralizing for a defense.
And it goes into the end zone, down for a touchback. They'll take over here, ready to start a new series. Now he's scrambling. He's to the 40. Tackle made right around the 44-yard line.
This is a pretty tough guy, and he's a great leader. He's going to do whatever it takes to help his team.
First down, 10 yards to go. Ball on their own 44. He scrambled. So the quarterback scrambles for about 2 yards on the play.
Yeah, it was a short gain, but a nice tackle there by the junior who stepped up in traffic and made a nice play.
Him hard at the 33-yard line. Flag down, and I'm not sure when it was thrown. Let's find out.
Offense.
Little stumbles like these can kill your offensive progress.
It's second and 7. Ball on their own 47. He's tackled around the 48-yard line. They go to the screen here, and the halfback's got it. He's tackled in the open field. From the 39-yard line, it's first down. He's scrambling, and he's taken down right around the 38-yard line. He scrambled, but he didn't get much.
Brad, this defense reacts too quickly for a scramble like that to work. He needs to spread him out a little bit more to try to create more room to run.
Try and scramble. Loose football. And the ball hawking safety scoops it out. That's a big break for this defense.
You know, this offense just can't afford to be getting hit with a turnover bug. They need to hold on to the football.
So it's time to see this offense go to work again.
This defense couldn't stop them from moving the ball and inevitably finding the end zone.
Gets the ball here and brought down in the backfield.
You know, as a running back, you've got to get upfield more than south. That time, he just seemed to wait and kind of delay his reaction and just got to be able to make a read, get upfield as quickly as possible. In college football, especially up in the NFL, the more you're dancing around waiting for a big play, the more time you're giving an athletic defense a chance to come and make a play in the backfield against you. And that's what happened.
First down, 10 to go. Ball on their own 33. They'll drop him for a loss. It's third down, and this offense is about 3 feet away from that first down marker. One more quarter to play. 31-14, Wildcats. Back in this very pivotal fourth quarter. Carries the ball for a nice game. That's a gain of 5 on the play. That makes it first and 10. First and 10. Ball on the 47-yard line. Zips it to the back. And they make the stop around the 39-yard line.
That's a gain of 13 yards on the play. First down.
out of bounds at the 37. Here's the eighth play of the series. That makes it 7-8. Quick throw. Brought down right around the 34. Third down again. To his back, and he's got him again. Tackle around the 36-yard line. 2-yard loss.
Really, they just had nowhere to go after the catch.
That brings us fourth and seven.
And it's the offense that takes the field on fourth down. To that quickly. He sheds it, and he's shoved out of bounds at the 30-yard line. The offense comes back out, and as I'm sure you'll remember, their last possession ended in a lost fumble.
Sometimes when you lose the football, you start to focus a little bit more, so a turnover can actually work out in your favor.
He gets out to about the 32-yard line.
That makes it 2nd and 8.
Second down, 8 yards to go. Ball on the 32. Just under 3 to go in regulation. Takes it up the middle for a nice run.
That'll bring up 34.
Screen pass incomplete.
This is simply just a miscommunication between a quarterback and a running back. Now, you don't see the quarterback throwing very often to the running back, and in this case, maybe it got him out of rhythm.
Ford is back awaiting the punt. They get this one off, and it's a beauty. Sheds a tackler, and he has it on the corner. He's tackled at the 17-yard line. Levine's game was off all day. I think you got to credit the defense.
Now, the defense came up with a plan to be able to take him out of the game, and it worked to perfection.
It's going to be interesting to see how the action shakes out in this series. Gets it. He's in space. And down he goes at about the 31. Can't get away from the pressure. It's third and long. Ball on their own 19. A little over a minute in the game. Quick throw out to the receiver. He's taken down at about the 49. Good tackle there in space. The Mustangs taking their first time out of the half. So it's second down now. They need about 4 yards to pick up the first. On the play. A 4-yard loss.
Well, that's just a sound play by the defense. They dropped him well short of the line of scrimmage.
They come out on an empty backfield. intercepted, and that should do it. That was a dangerous pass.
Well, you should have known better than to throw that football into coverage like that. You can't expect the receiver to come down with that ball.
We've got a first and 10. Ball on their own 38. And he'll just take a knee here to kill the clock. To about the 37-yard line. That makes it 3rd and 11. This one's in the books, and our final score, 31-14, Wildcats. That does it for this edition of NCAA Football 14. For Kirk Herbstreit, I'm Brad Nessler saying so long.